Hello everyone, this is Archer Fangs and welcome to another video of Terraria. So in the last part we actually went and mined Chlorophyte. We built the Chlorophyte armor set. Look, I'm wearing it. In today's part, I did little work of off camera before I head into the video of today. What I did is basically, let's just first show you what I'm going to show you is I built the arena for the Plantera boss fight. There are two campfires and four heart lanterns. Also, I cleansed some of the corruption in the jungle. I'm actually containing the corruption from spreading to the jungle. And there's a path there. And as well, when I was doing so, I bumped into the jungle temple. And it's dark, so the only way to access it is by getting the jungle key from Plantera. And we'll be able to go in there. Also, there were a lot of meteorites landing in my off-camera. I do not know why. One landed there, another one landed there. The one next to it was the first one we got in this playthrough. The other one landed there. Then remember, I also showed you that there was one right there and one in the desert. I fill in the gap with the sand and one right there too. So far there are like about 9 meteorites in this game. Even one landed in the sky island. Look, even the freaking house is gone. The wall is just there. But yeah. So this is the rest of the stuff I did. I found a magic quiver. What it does, it gives us a 20% chance to not consume arrow and increases arrow speed and damage by 10%. And from a dark mummy, I found a blindfold, which is another component for the ang charm. It gives you the immunity to debuffs or to darkness, and armor polish from a armor skeleton. I actually got two, and I got them while building the arena for Plantera. What this does, it gives immunity to broken armor. Basically, what broken armor does, it reduces your defense by half. So yeah. And from armor bones, I also received the legendary beam sword. And to be honest, I was surprised when I got this, cause I killed the armor bones, and I see something legendary on the little text that I picked up. I'm like, what the heck did I just picked up? And it was a beam sword. I did not even modify it. And from a Mi'kmaq, I got a dual hook. I think it's like another version of my hook. I also got the last mummy shirt. I also got 3 turtle shells. I found this philosopher's stone, which is a really great item for me to use right now. We also found this magic weapon, flower of frost. I think I got that from a Mi'kmaq as well, I think. And I also crafted the flamethrower. It's not that great. It uses yellow for ammo though, but it's a good weapon though if you carry it, you know, if you're like really range based. So yeah. So this is all the stuff I obtained. Before we do, we're gonna consume our hearts. Second of all, turtle shell is required to make turtle armor. Those are obtained by defeating the giant tortoise at the jungle biome. We're gonna take this. The only component for the amp char that I'm missing is a bazoor. I do not know why I'm missing that item, but I killed hundreds of moss hornets, and I have not attained them. So yeah, so first, we're gonna go right here. We're gonna move our band of regeneration. And we're gonna combine the thing. Also, I made another layer of chest. So this is accessory number 2. So this is like another area where I have for more room. And this is another blocks one because I need more room. This is vanity. This is under rest of the mummy pieces. And then the furniture. And then potions. I moved the potion from the bottom because I hardly access the potion chest. And this is a dirt and mud. Yeah, so I hardly access the potion chest. So I made this the boss prep chest because this is like stuff I needed so it can help me improve. The iron skin potions, you know, the magic build, if I ever go into magic build, the range potions and all that kind of stuff. So yeah, so I don't have to like be doing it on looking for each one of them and see what it does. So yeah, anyway, let's combine this stuff before we head into the video. So in today's video, we're going to fight Ocram, and this time we're gonna use range build. I don't like melee, but I'm gonna go range this time. So we're gonna equip this. Let's combine this. We got a couple of seconds before 7:30, 8 p.m. actually. Combining the banner of generation and the philosopher's stone, which you get it from killing Mix. You combine them to make the charm of myths. What it does is provides life regeneration and reduces the cooldown of healing potions. So yeah. So we got the Jag Charm of Myth, so 1% damage. Cool, cool, cool. Now that means when I drink potions, it will cut the potion sickness from by 25%. So instead of 60 seconds, it will be 45 seconds. So yeah. Also, while I'm here, let me just dump the rest of the stuff. So I still need a bazaar for the Ankh Charm. And let's take their last remaining life roots. So now we have max health. I literally got them by building the freaking Ankh Charm, the Pantera form. So the only downside about now is that I crafted the Chlorophyte armor, but I don't have no Chlorophyte weapons. I mine a bunch of Chlorophyte. I have it here a ton, 564. So I went out on a search for that off camera because I don't want to do another video of me looking for that. So instead, we're gonna smelt the bars and look through the weapon list before it's 8 p.m. So I made 128. So first, I wanna see, we have 65 defense. We have a Chlorophyte mask, which is 25 defense. I wanna look into the mask. I wanna get the range of helmet. This is 7, now this is magic. Where is it at? 13, so it's cut by a half. 16% increased range damage and 20% chance to not consume ammo. Here's the deal. I could craft that, or I could craft the turtle armor, which give me more defense. Here's the thing. I'm gonna craft the range helmet. We're gonna use it against Ocram, not Pantera. And then we're gonna craft, I'm gonna craft this one, the Chlorophyte Shot Bow. Cause I heard that this gun doesn't shoot just one arrow, but it shoots a tons of arrows. So it's kinda like the Clockwork Assault Rifle, the one you get from a Wall Flash. So it uses one ammo, and that one ammo shoots three ammo, but only consumes one. Which is great, so I'm gonna use that. And the pickaxe is almost the same thing as the pickaxe axe. It just only has +1 range and probably better melee damage. Yeah, it does. Alright, so So we're gonna craft the turtle armor, but I'm not gonna use it. Let's craft it. The turtle armor has more defense than the Chlorophyte armor. I think it goes up by 9 points total. Let's go look for the damn helmet. So we're gonna look through the arrows too. Okay, let's check this out. I'm gonna use this. Let's clip this here. I think it's already, I wasted too much time, isn't it? Holy shit. Okay, let's just get the arrows and let's fight him. Where are my Ichor arrows? I don't have any Ichor arrows. What the freak? Oh, you know what? Let's just craft some. And let's get the 99. Let's make these arrows. Damn, time went fast. 315, I don't think that's enough. We're gonna take... I'm thinking, what should I take? I'm just gonna take the Hellfires. Hellfire. If I ran out. No, what the heck? My controller's going crazy now. I'm gonna take a few of this. I'm gonna split them in half. Okay. Alright, so we're gonna get the summoning item. Where the heck is it? Here it is. Not that, what the heck, I'm trying to do this as quick as possible. And we're gonna get our potions. I'm gonna take boss prep. One of this. We're gonna take the pumpkin pie. Let's eat that. It has a 15 minute duration. And we're gonna take this, the archery potion. So let's go. Let's take the potions. Maybe I should wear my... You know what? I feel like I should just wear this instead. I already have this. 15% range damage. Let's summon him. This should be better. So this arrow, what it does is shoot the repeater. It shoots a ton of arrows. Kind of like a shotgun-ish for arrows. So let's defeat this guy once again. Cause last time we fell. We fell against Ocram. So far I'm doing good. I could have crafted some Chlorophyte arrows, but as you saw, we're running late. I want to defeat this guy as fast as I can before it hits morning. It's already changing to the other boss. The other form. Holy dang, dude. Let's get up here. So I'm already shooting the Hellfire arrows, I think. Using a potion to be safe. Let's go. So the Hellfire doesn't do any fire damage to him. It doesn't set on fire. Unless he's one of the bosses that cannot be on fire. Wait, he was on fire in another video though. Last time I fought him, but oh well. You know what? Let's switch to the Ichor arrows. There, we did it. We finally did the freaking Ocram. Nice, nice. We did it. So we defeated him. Did we got anything from him? We got his mask. Wow. Wow, wow, wow. And we got some Soul of Blight. And we got some spectral arrows from him as well. Cool, and we got some adamantite ore. And why the heck did we got lesser healing potion? That's strange. Wow. So we managed to defeat him. This time I did not die. Wow. So let's dump everything in here. Yep, yep, yep. Now we have more arrows. So that's cool. We have Ichor arrows. Let's leave them here. So we defeated him. Amazing. We got his mask. So our next boss fight is going to be Pantera. And I'm gonna still use range against it, but I'll be wearing the turtle armor. The only downside is that Plantera causes a poison debuff, and I don't have the Bazaar on me. I'm kind of thinking of going to my other world, you know, and get the Bazaar from that one, because in my other world, I tend to get a lot of Bazaars from the jungle. And I'm like getting annoyed because I defeated like a bunch of them. I defeated a bunch of moss hornets, a bunch of hornets, toxic sludges, and none of them ever drop a bazaar. So yeah. Okay, so we're gonna combine the components. So we need a czar. We need a trifle map. Unfortunately, we need a bazaar to combine against a adhesive bandage. We need the megaphone, the fast cog, and the vitamins, and the armor pouch goes with the vitamins, and then here goes the blindfold does not get combined yet though. It's the only soul item, the only item that's alone. So we go over here. The plan, counter course mantra, and armor bracing. So we have that. So we still missing the bazaar once again. All right, so I'm gonna leave this here. I'm gonna equip this. And just go to my range chest and dump the helmet. I don't know why I crafted the helmet though. I think I feel like I just wasted a bunch of ores there crafting it. I think it's just 12 ores, not that a lot. So, we got the mask. Let's equip it. Wow. We look like Ocram big time. We're gonna dump it in here. But the rest of our mask. So yeah. Anyways guys, that will be it for this video. If you enjoy it, hit the like button. If you're new to the channel, subscribe. If you have any comments or any questions or anything that you want to say about the video or about the channel, leave them down in the comments below. And as always, this is Ultra Fangs. I'll see you next time. Thank you for watching. Bye.